What makes a 3D printer a 3D printer? Well, it's the filament pushy bits and the filament melty bits, also known as the extruder and the hotend. On cheaper machines, those are often the parts that get replaced and upgraded first, because they're likely a limiting factor in what the machines can do, or a reliability issue when they're not built well, and frankly, many aren't. MicroSwiss is one of the options to go to then, and I think they're going about it with some really unique solutions. They asked if they could sponsor this video here from Earth, and by the way, if you're watching this early, Earth is happening right now, so if you're in the area, definitely check it out if you can.
Hey, my name is Alex, I'm with MicroSwiss. We make hotends, extruders and nozzles, and let's start with our newest addition to our line, is MicroSwiss NG, direct drive.
It's on an angle. Now, typically extruders are built with pretty strict 90 degree angles, so when you use them in a direct drive setup, you've either got the extruder motor hanging super low, which ends up restricting how well you can get to the print with part cooling fan ducts, or it's going to be mounted further up than it could be otherwise, which increases the length between the drive gears of the extruder and the nozzle. And in that section, the filament is going to be under compression. Why is that bad? Well, parts under compression like to buckle, and especially with softer and flexible filaments, your filament will too, and rub against the sides of whatever is guiding it, leading to friction and worse control over the filament flow. Now, with the NG, MicroSwiss simply took that motor and swiveled it out of the way, making for a super open and accessible hotend, and what they're claiming is the industry's shortest filament path at under 41 millimeters long. And as a bonus, this is also getting the weight of the motor closer to the extruder's center axis. Smart. Now, if you don't care too much about the super short filament path and you actually prefer super fast nozzle swaps, MicroSwiss are collaborating with E3D and now have a version of their NG extruder in development that fits E3D's entire Revo hotend system, including the Ob Obsidian, which is finally available now. The thing that MicroSwiss is really good at is making sure their extruders and hotends are easy to use and a drop-in replacement for tons of machines. The NG extruder, for example, directly fits the Ender 3 and CR10 and any other printers that share that geometry, and it converts them from a Bowden setup to a direct drive. That adds a little bit more weight on the toolhead, which the machines can handle, but just like I talked about the distance between the extruder and the nozzle being important for extrusion control, well, going from Bowden to direct drive reduces that length to about 1/10 of what it used to be. The NG is geared down 3:1. The classic direct drive extruder is a 1:1, but both are dual drive setups that really grip onto the filament they're driving. And both of them work with MicroSwiss's hotend.
And we do this a little bit different too.
So, first of all, this is an all-metal hotend, of course. The original Creality hotends use the plastic Bowden tube going all the way into the melt zone, and that is where they usually fail, and if you don't know what you're looking for, it can be super frustrating to diagnose. An all-metal hotend cuts out that failure point. It also allows you to print materials that require higher temperatures, but it can also melt filament faster than the lined hotends, because the PTFE tube in those essentially acts as an insulator throughout a large section of what is part of the melt zone in an all-metal one. Now, one of the things that MicroSwiss does differently is that they don't just offer plated nozzles, which you're probably familiar with for printing abrasive materials, but they also plate their heat breaks. Now, the plating they use is a nickel-based alloy, and yes, it is a durable, wear-resistant coating, but it's also low friction and keeps the filament from sticking to the walls in the inside of the heat break. The coated heat breaks and nozzles come as default on the MicroSwiss hotend, but they also make them as drop-in replacements for other standard hotends. It's always great to have options, and MicroSwiss certainly are one worth looking into if your machine is in need of an upgrade. Thanks again to MicroSwiss for sponsoring my trip to Earth, and if you make it here this year, say hello. Thanks for watching, keep on making, and I'll see you at Earth maybe.